Hello everyone and welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayashree this side. In today's tutorial, I will be sharing with you all a process on making a mixed media layout using the very gorgeous Hydrangea Lawns collection kit. But before we dive into the tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest videos. To begin with, I have here a 12x12 pattern paper pack of Hydrangea Lawns from Dress My Craft. I'm using two beautiful designs of papers from it and trimming down the excess from the top. Next, I'm taking one of the pattern paper and tearing it down in a random way to get two torn out pieces. I also decided to choose a different paper for my base as the one I chose before was too busy for the layout I had in mind. So I changed to a design which is much more simpler with just script all over it. Please do excuse me for my voice today as I have a throat infection and some sinus issues. I would still try my best to explain you the complete process. Moving on, I am inking all the edges of both the torn out pieces as well as the base paper using Distress Oxide in the color Faded Jeans. Once done inking, I am now adhering the two torn out pieces on top of each other using some 3D foam tape and then adhering them both on the base paper using some liquid adhesive. Vintage lace from Dress My Craft, which I plan on adhering on either side of the torn papers. But before I adhere it, I am going to add a thin layer of clear gesso on top of my pattern papers to protect it from any seepage of paints and inks. As the gesso dries, I am deciding as to where my focal image will go. Next, using Dress My Craft's mixed media stencils in the shapes honeycomb and vintage diamonds, I am adding some texture to my background. After the texture paste has dried, I am going to add some colors to the background. I am starting with Opal Magic acrylic paint in the color Blue Violet. I am simply spraying water on my pattern paper and then adding the paint to it. And I am going to move the paint around with my paintbrush. I am going to dry the paint before I go on to the next color. I'm using the color Aqua Rose next and repeating the same process. Darker tone, I am going in with the Distress Oxide color Faded Jeans. I have simply smooshed some ink on my non-stick craft mat from Dress My Craft and sprayed some water on it. Now using my paintbrush, I am simply adding the color to my textured area. Now while we let the paints dry, I am going to make some foliage die cuts using the newly launched Easy Cuts die cutting machine from Dress My Craft. I am using foliage and leaves die set number 8 and a 180 GSM black cardstock for the same. I am simply taking two sheets of the cardstock and placing it on the acrylic plate. Over this, I am placing my cutting die upside down and completing the sandwich by placing the second acrylic plate. I am going to roll the sandwich in the machine to and fro and voila, we have our crisp die cut. This die cutting machine is very handy and gives crisp and clear cuts on every use. To know more about the machine in detail, do check out our previous video, the link to which is given in the description box below. Now it's time to assemble all our embellishments and create the layout. For this, I am starting by adhering the vintage lace on either side of the torn pieces of pattern papers. I am distressing the edges a little on either side of my laces. Next, I am adhering some distressed medical gauze and adding my floral arrangement on top of it. I will be using some fussy cutout elements from the motif sheet of hydrangea lawns to add some more layers and interest to the floral arrangement. While I adhere all my embellishments in their places, why don't you hit the thumbs up button below the video if you are enjoying watching this tutorial. Also, the list of all the products used in this video tutorial are given in the description box below, so do check that out. A similar arrangement in the right side of the focal image as well. Once done adhering all the embellishments, I am going to adhere some chipboard behind my image to give it more dimension. Next, I am adhering the chipboard frame on top of the image for some extra interest. I have some hydrangea bushes fussy cut out from the motif sheet, which I am planning to adhere around the frame. And here our layout is ready. Later on, I also ended up adding some splatters using the diluted distress oxide color faded jeans around the floral arrangement and some bows made with satin twine from Dress My Craft. I hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial and are inspired to make your own. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already before you go. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye-bye.